Slaantjeba. Happy St. Patrick's Day. I want to make sure y'all understand this is a 100% true story. On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet Cove of Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. Was a wonderful craft, she was rigged for an act. And oh, how the wild winds drove her. She'd stood several blasts, she had 27 masts, and we called her the Irish Rover. We had 1 million bags of the best Sligo rags, 2 million barrels of stones. We had 3 million sides of old blind horses' hides, and 4 million barrels of bones. We had 5 million hogs, and 6 million dogs, 7 million barrels of porter. We had 8 million bales of old nanny goat's tails in the hold of the Irish Rover. Too bad we forgot the bricks, but there's always extra. Or not. There was old Mickey Coop, who played hard on his flute when the ladies lined up for his set. In his bootleg skin for a sparkling quadrille, though the dancers were feathered and wet. With his sparse, sweaty talk, he was cock of the walk. They rolled the dames under and over, for they knew at a glance when he took up his stance that he sailed in the Irish Rover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. There was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Jimmy McGirt, who was scared stiff of work, and the man from Westmeath called Malone. There was Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a room, and Fighting Bill Tracy from Dover. And your man, Big McLean from West Michigan, he came to be the skipper of the Irish Rover. For a sailor, it's always a bother in life, it's so lonesome by night and by day. Sure, and the charming young will mount all his troubles away. All the noise in the rout, so inviting and stout, for him soon the torment is over. Of the love of a maid, he is rarely afraid, an old sock from the Irish Rover. When the measles broke out and the ship lost its way in a fog, and the whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's old dog. Then the ship struck a rock, oh Lord, what a shock! The bulkhead was turned right over. She turned 9 times around and the poor old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish Rovers.